So aggressively loud. You don't like being woken up by the birdies?
No.
What about the dogs?
No.
Or the chupacabras?
There's no chupacabras.
Oh, they are.
No.
I saw one yesterday and I heard them
It was a
all
dog.
night. It was a
No, it
chupacabra.
was not. It was a
I
dog.
wish I had my phone so I could have taken a picture of the chupacabra that we saw.
It was a dog.
What time is it?
Like 7:10.
And has this noise been going on for a while?
Yes, like an hour.
I was thinking more like 10 hours because it was all night.
Oh, I was asleep.
The dogs were all night. Now the birds are this morning.
Pulled up to the church, but I got so nervous. Had to back it on up, couldn't make it to the service. Grabbed all the cash underneath my mattress. Got a real good feeling something bad about to happen. Ran into a girl in a pretty white dress. Rolled down the window, where you headed to? Said I'm headed to the bar with my money out the mattress. Got a real good feeling something bad about to happen.
Are the hieroglyphs that tell what about the kings and about the city here in Ekbalam. So Haley, where are we going now?
To the top.
To the top of what?
The pyramid.
To the top of the pyramid. Like, way up there? Are we going up there?
Yes.
Are we gonna die? Is this how we die in Mexico?
No.
Okay. You have another way for us to die planned?
Yes.
Okay. All right, up we go.
These stairs are going to be fun.
Okay.
Having fun? And this is all the original plaster work.
This was found buried behind another facade. This is the mouth of a monster. It's the earth monster. There's his teeth, and his palate is right here with teeth above. And look at all of the people. So it was all found in like excellent shape. Halfway up the pyramid.
Did you make it?
I did. Can I fall?
Nope. Mother. And out there you can see other parts and nothing but jungle.
Oh no, those mounds over there with all the tall ones with all the trees on them.
Well, those are buildings that haven't been discovered yet.
Those are unexcavated.
Was it worth it?
Yeah. Pyramid climbing for the win.
That down there is a sleeping dog.
It's a chupacabra.
Dog.
Chupacabra.
Dog.
It's tiny and it's way down there. How can you tell it's not a chupacabra?
Because I walked past it and it was a dog.
You don't know what you're talking about.
I know what a dog
chupacabra.
Is.
Chupacabra. Yeah, a dog is a taco. Haley has a super dislike of heights. I don't think she's enjoying this.
It's like
healthy fear.
Healthy fear.
Are you gonna die? Maybe. Okay. Don't worry, I'll video it if you're dying. Scream so it'll be more dramatic. I successfully did not die climbing the pyramid at Akbalam. Jury's still out on Haley. That Mayan bed.
You're disturbing my nap.
Doesn't look very comfortable. Are you napping?
Shh.
Because you climbed the pyramid and now you're tired?
Yes.
Fat girl should not climb the pyramid?
Fat girl should climb the pyramid. And take a nap afterwards.
Okay. All right. I'm going to go get some, like, honey and Mexican chocolate. You enjoy your nap. Goodbye. Hi guys.
Malukincho, Isabel, kimakpiolek puksika yung botik tech ujatala shimba ton. Yung botik, yo.
Haley is standing in the middle of what they found as a road between this ruin and another one. You see the outline of the road on either side. It's a little tree-y now. But maybe they wanted to like walk in the shade. Or maybe it was just that, you know, that was like thousands of years ago. Because what do they say? Akbalam was found like 1800 AD? I'm sorry, 800 AD, right?
Yeah. That's when it was flourishing.
That was when it was flourishing. So, you know. Akbalam, which means starred jaguar?
Yes. Recognize I have a very, very healthy fear of heights. Like, I've never let it stop me from doing anything, but like my legs start shaking real bad, and like even when I worked on the ropes course, I did it, know I was safe, was fine, didn't stop my legs from shaking. So coming down the pyramid was a very interesting. I was like shaking like this.
Did you know you were safe on the pyramid?
That was a little debatable. If I tripped, I would have died.
But that's not how we die in Mexico.
No.
No, we made it down?
We made it down.
Was Akbalam worth the trip?
Yes.
And what did we spend total?
I don't know. Mexican money doesn't exist. It's monopoly.
So, like, $800 for the tour, or for entrance. $600 for a tour, so $14. $100 to pay the Mayan guys that we had our pictures with, so $1,500, $70 for drinks, and $50 for the guy that babysat my car.
Yep.
So $1,700, which is, do that math,
like $80.
So $80, I'll take it.
It was correct, and it was not.
I thought you knew where we were going. Not to
we're
find
turn
the
around.
Turkeys. Don't pull off the road here. Go up to where it's wider, because I don't want to get stuck. Or eaten by the turkey.
Turkey's not going to eat us.
Look, it's wider up here.
We eat turkey.
I thought you know how to get back to the hotel or to the... I don't like
we
this.
We are adventuring in Mexico.
I don't know what that sign says, but...
Bienvenidos means goodbye, I think.
Oh, are we leaving Akbalam to go? This isn't a road.
Yeah, it is. It's what they call roads in Mexico. Look, there's a flower. Focus on the pretty flower.
Instead of the dying?
This is not how we die in Mexico.
Oh, you've got that planned out already.
Yeah. Avocado Kraken.
What?
It's a surprise.
Well, hello there, pretty. Did you come to say hello to us? The kitty obviously does not care about the birdies. Look. So pretty. Roast them.
Nashunang está trabajando.
Not that easy, is it?
You're just pitiful. Is that the heaviest rolling pig you've ever picked up?
See.
smells so good.
Oh my gosh, it does. And it's all stone. Did we roast them first? And they were caliente?
Let's see.
And now Haley gets to try this. How you doing there?
I'm not as good.
I don't hear any crunching. All I hear is scraping of rock on rock. Is the table a little bit short? Haley, have you gotten the hang of this yet? Can you live in a Mayan village?
Probably not. I would starve.
How short is the table?
Short. Mucho.
Look at all the smoke from the fire in here. You're trying to push it. She was just rolling and sliding it across. Does that make sense?
Yeah. So I suck.
Basically, yes.
Wow.
A little bit different in size.
Just a little bit. Grande.
Grande. Not grande. Did you hit your head?
Yes.
So you want to talk about what we just did?
Made Mayan hot chocolate from hand.
How was that?
Well, it was definitely very different than American chocolate, that's for sure, but... I mean, started with the cacao beans, roasting them, shelling them, and then grinding them with a rock that had been in her family for hundreds of years.
She said several generations, right?
Yeah. And just grinding it and grinding it and grinding it and grinding it some more, like 20 minutes. Just.
And how does your arms feel?
Well, I don't feel like I ever need to work them out again, okay? Work out for a lifetime. And then... mixing it with water and sugar and cinnamon and...
Was it good?
It was so good. Unlike anything I've ever drank before. Definitely nothing like, you know, American hot chocolate.
Did you expect to come to the jungle in Mexico and drink hot chocolate?
No.
And do we have some leftover we can take home with us? Or drink tomorrow?
If it makes it that far, sure.
And the best part about the experience?
I think the most beautiful part was we speak no Spanish, and the lady who did this for us spoke no English, or very, very, very little, and yet I feel like I walked out of the experience learning something new and understanding something, and gives you a whole appreciation, like, just because you don't necessarily understand what they're saying, it's people just living their lives every day. And
even with a language barrier, we were still able to connect. And where's our little napkin?
Handmade napkin.
And how much did she want for it?
100 pesos, which is like $5.
Was it worth it?
Yes.
We are taking the walk to the Sacagawea Cenote.
Okay, the tree went funny.
Oh, it grabbed your mask. So, does anyone here hablo inglés?
No.
Hablo...
Español y Mayan.
Ah. Has that been a problem?
No, not particularly.
All right, here we go. Into the Mayan underworld. Haley, is this how you die in Mexico?
No.
You only paid the answer.
Mom.
Nope.
Come on.
Bye.
They're not going to eat you. They're not that big.
Sea krakens.
No.
Cenote kraken.
Mama. Guess what? You're not dead.
Are you, like, booking kraken area?
It's
really kind of magical.
Thank you.
so proud of you. You are okay. We are in the ground, swimming in a cave. And she's freaking out.
There's fish in here.
And yet you're not dead.
Is this how I die in Mexico?
No.
There's no chupacabra in here.
Is the current pulling you away?
A little bit.
That was my plan. This is how you die in Mexico.
Tis not. The sun is leaving us, though.
Yeah, the sun is going away. I'm a little concerned about being down here in the dark.
Maybe that's why it closes at 4, Mama.
Huh. Oh, something just touched my leg, and I didn't like it. Oh, wait, it was my other leg.
So dumb. What's your problem? Oh, that's a big old fishy right there. Hello, fishy friend.
Nope.
Go say hello to her. No. Oh, she's coming to you.
It's a ginormous fishy friend.
Oh, my friend's coming to say hello.
Look at him. Go under and look at
him. Where?
Take a video right here.
Where? Hey, Mom. Remember when I told you before we came to Mexico that there were going to be fish in all the water and we were planning on swimming every day? And you're like, it's going to be fine. You do not look very fine.
It's not fine. I don't like fish. There's cenote cracking down there.
Oh, do you want to say the words then?
I am not saying that you were right.
But I am right?
No, you are not right. I will get back in the water.
I am not convinced. Don't look down, it's very dark.
Yeah, don't tell me that.
Okay, Mama. Was that all bad?
There's fish in here.
And you're in here too, and you're not dead, so it's not all that bad.
No. It's actually very pretty. Kind of peaceful and enjoyable when I'm not worried about getting eaten by a cenote kraken.
And we make our climb out of the cave and back to the real world. Okay.
Out of the cave.
¿Dónde está la biblioteca? Doesn't look much help.
Black Panther assault in the world, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that an avocado kraken? Fresh guacamole at the table.
Mama.
Hey.
Yes.
Haven't I done enough steps tonight?
No.
Why are you making me do this?
Come on. It's okay.
If I fall and die, where are we going?
going? We're gonna get locked out here, aren't we? Oh, they're just up there. It's very dark here. There's the pool and the cenote. Oh my gosh, it really is a balcony. Like a, what the heck? This is on top of our hotel room tonight.
Stand on the box, stomp your feet, start clapping. Got a real good feeling, something bad about to happen. Pulled up to the church, but I got so nervous. Had to back it on up, couldn't make it to the service. Grabbed all the cash underneath my mattress. Got a real good feeling, something bad about to happen.